Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at parallelograms. Before we actually look at the properties, let's see where the parallelograms fall in the quadrilateral family. Okay, a parallelogram is a four-sided polygon, which means it's a quadrilateral. So it is under the big umbrella of quadrilaterals. There's another part of this diagram that we can't see, so we're looking at the side of the quadrilateral family that are all parallelograms. And under parallelograms fall these other three figures, a rectangle, rhombus, and a square. But let's look at the properties of just a general parallelogram. Okay, a parallelogram has several properties. The definition of a parallelogram is that the opposite sides, so AT and MH, would be parallel to each other, and we show that with a symbol of an arrow, and MA and HT would also be parallel. That's just the definition of a parallelogram. Now, some other properties are going to be that the opposite angles are congruent, meaning if angle A is 100 degrees, the angle on the opposite side of the parallelogram would also be 100 degrees. So angle A, the measure of angle A, would be the same as the measure of angle H. Okay, meaning also that angle M and angle T also have congruent measures. That's one of the properties. The next property is that the opposite sides are parallel. Okay, this side MA, is also congruent. MA, that side MA is congruent or the same length as HT. So they have the same length. So if this side is 5, this side is 5. And the same with AT and MH. MH. So let's say this is 8, then this opposite side would be 8 also. So opposite sides are congruent. Okay, then you also have one more property, and that is that these adjacent angles, adjacent meaning next to, so these are the opposite and these are the adjacent. These adjacent angles are supplementary. So if we know that this angle is 100, this angle M must be 80 because supplementary means they add to 180. So that means this angle is 80 and this angle up here is 80 because these two are also supplementary because they are adjacent to each other, and we know these two are opposite angles are congruent too. So let's look at the list of all this. You can freeze your video right here if you need to. Here are all the properties, and I hope this video was helpful for you to go through the properties of parallelograms.